Imagine a train with super speed, reaching approximately 180 kilometers per hour on a high-speed track. Inside, you'll find a wonderful interior, featuring comfortable seats and wide windows. The sight of two such trains passing side by side is truly beautiful. Consider the ingenuity involved in developing its remarkable bogies, modern pantograph, and entirely new electrical equipment. This is India's first semi-high-speed train, the Vande Bharat, a true game-changer. The coaches are made of stainless steel, with continuous window glass for a contemporary modern look. All coaches are interconnected by fully sealed gangways so that passengers can move from one coach to another coach. The doors of the coaches are provided with automatic plug type with retractable footsteps, which open and close automatically at the stations. This train consists of four basic units. There are four coaches in each unit. The configuration of both the front and end basic units are DTC, MC, TC, and MC. DTC stands for Driver Trailer Coach. Inside the DTC coach, you'll find the dashboard and all the operating equipment. MC stands for Motor Coach. Examining the bogie of an MC coach, you'll see the traction motors. Each motor is fitted to an axle and connected to a gearbox. TC is a trailer coach. Notably, only the trailer coaches have a pantograph mounted on their roof. Compared to Fiat bogies, this bogie features a new and wonderful design. The coaches utilize a BOBO bogie assembly. These bogies are bolsterless designs, equipped with fully suspended traction motors and a pneumatic secondary suspension system. An electro-pneumatic EP brake system is employed, where the brake discs are mounted directly on the wheels. Engineered for enhanced safety, this more powerful brake system significantly reduces the required braking distance, allowing for quicker and more controlled stops. This is a self-propelled train, so it doesn't need a separate locomotive. This is achieved through its electric multiple units, EMUs, which function as self-driving coaches. The main component is the traction motor, which is integrated with the bogies. Thus, the train does not require an external locomotive. This train works the same as an electric loco. Have you seen this? You can check the above link. First, electricity is drawn from the overhead equipment, OHE, via the pantograph. Next, the high voltage current is sent to the transformer. Its primary function is to transform the energy received from the catenary into the appropriate voltage and current for the traction and auxiliary converters. The output voltage from the transformer is then transferred to the line converter and the traction converter, and both are under the coach cubicle. This is a motor coach. Every motor coach has two LTC, line and traction converter. Here, the AC current is converted to DC current by the line converter, and then the DC current is converted back to AC current by the traction inverter to achieve variable voltage and variable frequency, VVVF. This variable AC output is then sent to the three-phase traction motors. Finally, the rotation of the motor and gear assembly drives the wheels. There is a wealth of technology on this train. The recent launch, the sleeper coach, means that long-distance journeys can now be undertaken with this high-speed train. Still now, we are working on the sleepers class, and I think it's a game-changer for Indian Railway. But what do you think? Share your comment. Thank you.